When people ask if students are prepared for today's jobs and jobs for the future, my answer is always yes, if. And let me explain. Yes, depending on what kind of institution the students are studying into and what is the needs for those skills in the labor market. The reasons for the if is because what is the most important aspect that institutions can do for students is instill in students lifelong learning. Because it's not because you have studied in a given field, in a given institution, that you're ready for life. Because as you know, things change constantly. The second thing after lifelong learning, it is to ensure that the students have what we call the soft skills, which are very important skills, whether it is teamwork, whether it is to ensure that they have critical thinking, because it's very important not just to say what you're being asked to do, but also to questions if it makes sense and maybe there's a better way to do it. Third, what I would say, what is very important is that the students learned how to work with leading edge equipment. The link to that is of course to know how to master technology or to have computer skills. Nowadays you can mine at a desk on the 21st floor of a building and do mining. So of course you need to ensure that in whatever jobs that you are aiming at, that you ensure that you master your use of computer. From a government perspective, some of the important step that I would say that would be crucial is first one, labor market information. Students and parents need to know what are the job prospects. Second one is to ensure that there are scholarships available for students that are studying in vocational and technical educations. It is crucial. It is as important to have scholarships for those fields as it is for university students. Third is to ensure that there is a accreditation systems to ensure that there are standards that are common so that when students come out after their program, it is well recognized because there were national standards that had been put in place. Fourth, it's important that the teacher training is crucial. Teachers need to ensure that they often upgrade their own skills and also to ensure that they don't just do theory. When we talked about TVET, it is very important to have applied learning. And fifth, it would be to encourage the industry, in fact, to offer internships. Because it is crucial that the students get hands-on on the job so that after they are able to go and see, they have already experience in the job. And I would add something that China, in fact, is putting in place right now when they are looking at the key performance indicators. They just introduced new key performance indicators, and one of them is the internationalizations of their educational institutions. I think this is crucial because it's very important that government also encourage their own educational institutions in looking at what is being done around the world to ensure that at all time the country is competitive on the global market. There are many ways that a country such as China can learn from other countries and vice versa. It's very important for other countries to learn from China. For example, let's talk about Canada. Canada and China have been partnering with the leadership training program by which we have the heads of colleges from China that come to work in Canada, not to work in Canada, I'm sorry, to receive a one-month training. And what they are able to do is learn about how Canada is doing with vocational and technical education. And also the second and the third week, the heads of the college in China or paired with heads of colleges in Canada, and they literally job shadow them for a week at a time. And the fourth week, all the heads of colleges of China get together, share what they've learned during their second and third week, but also develop a plan of action. And what was very interesting is that about 2 weeks ago in Beijing, we had a reunion of 40 alumni that took that program in Canada. And they were 40 alumni from China. And they shared with us not only what they had done since they had come back, but also they talked about the partnerships that they had developed between Canada and China. And this has been very fruitful for both countries because there have been twinning of students, there have been twinning of teachers, there have been also joint curriculum development that have happened. Students from each other country came also to spend time, to spend a semester in each other country. So really great way to learn from each other, but also to make the world a better place.